Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to Ollyiceman Gaming. I am Ollie. Back with some more Formula One. On to the third race of the season in Shanghai, China. The race is in the rain. Fuck. That's not good. Well, the race is in the rain. You now know that. But yeah, I've done the practice session. Now moving into Qualies. Done a couple of upgrades on the R&D path on this one so far, so got a couple more that are coming this weekend, like a power and a aerodynamics upgrade, I believe, and then I've just done a couple more as well, so there's another power one coming, and then there's another one coming at Monaco as well. The Monaco one's the under tray, so it should give me a bit better traction and better downforce. And going around Monaco, because God knows you need that shit. First time using these hypersoft tyres, they are fucking lovely, hey, especially on a track like this. There's some really hairy corners, like the first corner of Shanghai is just probably the most technical corner that there is on the calendar. You'll see what I mean after this. Great start. Right, concentrate. Ridiculous. Oh, mate. Concentrating on too many other things. Oh, fuck that up. Do this again. This track's grown on me over the years. I hated it when I first started playing these games, like back when, was it F1 2010? It was the first game, I think. I hate this track. It's grown on me over the years, as I've understood driving more. The semantics of Formula One. It's become a bit more enjoyable, because it's quite a fast-paced one. Definitely a fast-paced racetrack sort of thing. Much worse on the slower tracks. Oh, I thought that would be corner cutting me. Really did. Yeah, boy. Popping in that tyre quicker than Seb.
You've dropped down to P2.
So in my head, I'm like already thinking about strategy for the race, like tyre strategy. I am really intrigued to see if the medium tyre is available for this race. I doubt it will be, because we've got the ultras. We tend to have normally three compounds, and then both the wets. So like, this would be the ultras, the hypersofts, the ultrasofts, and then the soft. I have to check. I don't think I DRS down the straight. Yeah, let's see. Because in reality, I'd like to qualify like 11th and then start with the mediums. Yeah, see, mediums are available. Do I have a fresh set? Yeah, I do. Because if I could do a one-stop race doing like... Oh, no, wait, it's a wet race anyway, isn't it? Yeah, it's going to be raining. Yeah, there you go. Damp conditions with light rain. Okay. So, yeah. Best of the rest, apart from Seb. Ah, Seb just didn't want to use his ultras. Well, the computer decided that Seb didn't want to use his ultras. So in reality, I don't want to put in a really good lap time in this. No, I do. Stop being a fucking idiot. It's gonna rain. Going to be wet in the race. It's not going to be wet though, is it? It's damp conditions with potential for light rain. So we are going to have to start on softs. Let's do one lap in these. Make it a good one. Lockups. Any flat spots. Time later. Yep. Guess you out wide for that, so you can carry even more speed into this one. Break, break, break. Much better. Brake on the 100. Late turning. Cut back, cut back. Fucked that a little bit. Half throttle, three quarters, and full. Durs! Brake. I like that. How much wear? What? Why have I used a worn set? Oh, because that's Q3. Okay, cool.
So far, our fastest lap is a 1:36.0.
think the game might be needing to be made a little bit harder. It's on expert though. Anyone who's watched this is the first video they've watched, if this is the first video they've watched of me, it's all assists off apart from automatic gearbox, and I have and pit assists. Got the difficulty set to 80 so far. To start on 89, but I'd want a few races to get into the flow of this game again. So yeah, it's down at 80, which is still classed as expert. It's only one setting higher, which is master. No, there's legend as well, which is above 95, but legend is just terrifying. They hit pretty much exactly the times they hit in real life, which is just not a chance. Not for someone like me. Fuck this lap.
Fuck
it, doing one more lap. That's a little bit of practice before the race. Nope. I just wasn't concentrating enough. But it doesn't matter.
As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Vettel, Raikkonen, and Daniel Ricciardo. It's...
It seems like the power upgrades that we've done have helped. It was a massive power upgrade as well. Yeah, I'm losing. Red Bull, like, nah, fuck you. We're not impressed. Alright.
Well done. That was a good qualifying performance.
The car has a water bottle, so make sure you keep hydrated. It'd be cool if there was an option to actually do it. I mean, I'd probably only ever do it once, but if I could select to have a drink, that'd be quite cool. Pointless. But cool. Fucking sleepy. You know, it's only 5 o'clock.
Massa passed Jensen Button into turn one at the very first Chinese Grand Prix in 2004. Shanghai has consistently provided close racing and extraordinary memories. It's where Lewis Hamilton effectively lost the title in his rookie year, and it's where Nico Rosberg played Mercedes well then after an exciting qualifying session.
Don't like rain.
We're higher on the grid than we expected. Let's see if we can do even better.
Intermediates, though, so it's not the worst thing in the world. 31 laps, no. We're fueled for 29. Pleased with the start, yes. Going around the outside, such a nice cheeky little technique for this. Seeing Ricciardo and Verstappen do it, Hamilton do it.
Well done, mate. Nice start.
Thanks, mate. Fucking not very nice out here, Jeff. Sorry, but collision with Bottas, fuck off. Could have seen me re-entering. No, that was definitely too late. That Bottas. What the fuck? Perfectly side by side, accelerating nicely, and he just decides to cut across the track and brake. Crazy. Right. I'm gonna try and stop doing rewinds now. Now the pack's split up a bit. Track is so fun in the dry. Why did they?
Be careful with the front wing. You've taken some minor damage.
Have I? Oh, so I have. Fuck. Don't repair my way. fuck off, Rhino. That guy that just came online, he's a mate of mine. I was chilling with him, and he wanted to go on this, and I was saying, yeah, go on and chuck it on. He's a big Formula One fan as well, and he just couldn't do it. The guy is incredible at Halo, right? And like Overwatch, and PUBG, and all these shooting games, he's incredible. He's got some of the most amazing kill cams you can ever see, you've ever seen. But yeah, he just can't do this, and it really frustrated him. He's South African as well, so it fucking pissed him off. You just see the anger building up in him. Do I have a massive queue of people behind me? Yeah. I've got the whole pack behind me there. And Bottas right in front of me. So it shows I'm not doing terribly. Yeah, pitting on 14 seems realistic. Only 11 laps left in this fucking horrible weather.
The heavy rain will pass in about 5 minutes. We'll be working with light rain conditions.
I was going to say, this doesn't seem like light rain. For the UK, I'm pretty much an expert on rain now. This does not seem like light rain. It's not heavy rain though. Fucking Brits. I just released the brake then and it wouldn't stop locking up. I can't tell whether I'm keeping ahead of these people because I'm doing well or because I'm struggling, but there is Verstappen there. I mean, Verstappen's not a win. Oh, Hülkenberg, that was so early. Don't mind one bit of my wing gone, but not both my fingers. Max, fuck off. Stay on the wet ground. I have the nice dry racing there. What is he even doing? So I'll push you off the line. I can drive aggressive. Without ramming you. It's good though, I've got a nice little friend unit of people that all drive in a correct manner. I ram in, if it is, it's unintentional, we slow down, we let the other person back past again, you know, it's... We're all genuine. Genuine races, which is hard to find on these games nowadays. Thing is, though, in Formula 1, if you play online, someone rams you, fuck. Your car's fucked, their car's fucked, so you might as well just try and race properly. If you can't do it, then fuck off and quit. Go practice more. Feels like I have a spider on my face. I'm gonna have to check this out. 2 seconds. Go away, bug of doom. I did have a spider on my face. I have a beard, so it's hard to tell sometimes. Oh, come on, stop locking up on that one. Come with me, Nicker. Yellow flag.
Okay, clear.
in that corner. Who went off? I didn't want that. Oh, I didn't want that. God damn it. I'm doing the wrong things. I'm trying to focus. I'm trying to see what's going on with my teammate. I don't want... It's not that far away.
The time last lap was a 1:55.8.
Oh. Jesus.
Okay, the weather's certainly eased off for the time being, but we've still got a lot of standing water out there. We're happy for you to stay out on the inters for now.
Fucking hell. Starting to lose grip on these things. Oh fuck Grosjean, he deserves a collision. That has caused so many collisions in this time. Why? You were on the racing line, why? Do I always look up on that? Tires are too hot, cooling down a little bit. I'm on this fucking racing line. Something's gone weird with this car. It's just locking up all the time. I just don't get it. Even then, look, didn't even jam the brakes on that hard. That, look, that's half, that is half throttle, half trigger braking, just fucking speak right. It's not even a heavy compression. See, now it's just got me worried, like, stupid car. I preferred it when it was fucking pissing it down. The tyres have just given up. Look at it, look! I'm definitely going to pit now, because like this, like, these tyres are dying. 42%. I think it's just got too dry for them. Now it's just tearing them apart. So look at it, look. They're just locking up everywhere. See if anyone joins me. One person joined me. Who and what are they getting? Another set of inters. I like this though. Fresh tyres. Safety car. My team. So someone's actually out. I don't know why I'm rushing. Safety car, Ollie. I am purposely driving in the water right now. I'm trying to keep the tyres cooler. Don't need them all warm and tearing chunks off of them right now. Just need to catch up with that fucking pack. So funny, there was a race that happened. I can't remember if it's start of this season or it was the end of last season, but there was a race where it was so wet on the track that people, like two, three cars spun out under safety car, I think. And then they just red flagged the race, so they were like, yeah, let's restart this a little bit later. It's really funny. Never seen it before personally. Not that many crashes on the safety car. I was looking at all the stats. I'll stay behind Grosjean.
Okay, take it easy.
What? Oh yeah, I've got no heat at all.
Let's catch up to the field a bit. We're dropping too far back. Remember that we need to stay within 10 car lengths of the next car.
Should have got my front wing done, really.
Okay, take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage. Right, pick up the pace a touch, please. We need to close to within 10 car lengths of the car ahead. Inters look like the best tyre for now.
Now, I don't need to know about the tyres. I want to know... When's this rain gonna stop? If it's gonna stop.
Safety car in this lap. Safety car in this lap. Let's make sure those tyres are up to temperature, and remember there is no overtaking until the first safety car line. Stay in position until the green flags.
Can't be slow enough down here. This is miles before. Safety car's gonna get in. Can't overtake until the first safety car line, it's so annoying.
That move was reckless.
I can't believe that. They just literally sandwiched the shit out of me.
Give that position back. We are under safety car conditions and cannot overtake. Return the position.
Can now though. No heat in the tires at all. Rain seemingly got worse. Tyres are going to be in much better condition than this.
I think we're still on the right tyres for the time being.
Do you think? Doesn't really take a genius, Jeff. Starting to think maybe pitting wasn't a good idea.
We're trailing our teammate by 5.4 seconds. They're on old inters. The time last lap was a 2:44.7.
Start fucking moving again. Good. Took that one wide. Nice and wide. Side, hopefully. Come on, Charles. How are you going to in any way, shape or form say that was my fault, that second one? I give you the first one, but the second one, nah, not a chance. Oh, the arse nearly kicked out so hard. Fuck you. Oh, Grosjean, fuck off. How have you got so much more speed? Clear batch on its way. I'll get out of the way.
He advised moving to mix 2. Fuel to mix 2.
Oh my god, these fucking... Sabres need to get out of the way. Good, it's like the right amount of rain is here now to make these tyres work.
A new strategy is available on the MFT.
Fucking new strategy. Unless it says we're going to fit brakes that don't lock up every time you get on that corner. I don't care. No. Keep current. If we do that, I'm going to have to pit a fucking game. Yeah, clever move. Fuck you. I'm not really a fan of the rain anyway, but this isn't going too bad. This is the best, but... I think pitting before the safety car was unrequired. I should have just waited. Well, I don't know, I'd have been pitting now. Like a 33% wear into these already, so. The wear just literally comes from those lockouts. That's the only problem with ABS being turned off. It's fucking tough to manage. Oh yeah, that's why I don't use my wheel with this game. So yeah, all of the Formula 1 so far, they've not allowed you to remap the pedals to how you want them. And the G920, Logitech G920 race wheel, it's got the most firm brake pedal in the world. And I literally cannot push it to full compression. That's fucking terrible. Cannot push it to full compression. It's not to do with my strength or anything like that, it's just the thing will not go fully down. The clutch will. So I try and remap the brake pedal to the clutch. See that? Look at that! Just locking up entirely that whole way. So I try and map the brake pedal to the clutch. It's just never letting it. Now the tyres just want to take that corner. At least they don't call it corner cutting. I'm doing shocking right now. It's just because I'm not concentrating, spending too much time chatting. People watching these videos don't care about me chatting, they care about me racing well. What I'm not doing.
Okay, gap ahead is 1.7
why
seconds.
Why it won't stop? Shut up, I've got two dogs and they're just fucking both barking outside. Oh, just fucking locking up, mate. Doing my bean. Where do you want me to brake? On the 150? What? Fucking hell. See, look, it's not on the 150, is it? So where the fuck do you want me to brake? I just don't. I've played every single one of these games, so I have a right to fucking say what I think about these games. And every single game, there is one or two corners that they just. They're like bogey corners on every single game. Like, they change every game. I know I can do those corners. I've done them for years on previous games. And then they change certain aspects, and now they're just fucking every single time, like that. Like, every single time I approach that corner, fucking lock up. That's just not realistic.
We're expecting you in around 2 laps, and we'll be putting you on the intermediate tyres. The gap behind us is 1.9 seconds.
Team's gonna be fucking pissed at me as well.
Gap to car in front is 3.1 seconds.
Oh, you qualified like 5th or whatever and finished like 14th. Oh, fuck off. Thank you. barely any spray coming off the car. I'm tempted to go onto some slicks. There's so much standing water on these corners still. Which is wrong, because that's a camber. That water should all fucking drain off the round bottom. Look at my teammates in the pits. I swear it's just too dry now for these tyres. Mate, the guy has completely fresh tyres on. Look at these pieces of shit. 57% wear, you expect me to be competitive? These are like the most irritating interchangeable conditions. Like, it's been wet the whole time, but the racing line is dry. Ish. So my tyres get torn to shreds. I'm not getting any vibration through the controller as I turn corners. Oh. Maybe I am, but the batteries are getting low. What? Alright, 2 seconds. Sorry about that, I went for piss as well. Not that you need to know that.
Oh, I pressed A.
God damn it. Yes. I tried to brake then as hard as I possibly could. Before it locks up. It locks up instantly. I've got to get these tyres off. I know, Sergio, I know. You and all your mates behind, you're all just going to fuck off, aren't you? Hitting on that safety car was a stupid idea. Oh my god, look at it! It's just the most ridiculous thing! No driver ever says anything about this. You're never like, oh yeah, you know, when you go out on inters and you fucking spend some time out there, eventually they get really shit and you lock up all the time. It's just not the case. It does happen, but not every single fucking high speed corner. I'm applying half brakes. Half. And it's locking up. This is ridiculous.
Complete, go now.
Didn't change the fucking wing either. Fuck's sake.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Let me go then. fucking didn't let me accelerate and then shot me off. Well, I blame the team for that one. They were like, wait, look, here's a strategy change. Alright, I'll trust the team. Go with your strategy. Oh, well, look, it's fucked me and put me one position from the back. Cheers, guys. One thing that really gets me about this game as well is the first season. Make the weather true to how it's been in the real world. It's hard to program that in.
It looks like we'll be running on a dry track soon. Back to dry shortly.
Did he just say what I think he said? Track will be back to dry shortly. I should have put on a set of slips. Look at the three of us who pitted under safety car. All of us just rocking around at the back. The thing that gets mine, does my nut in, is I'm just not going to beat Van Doren. I just want to beat my teammate. It's one of the most important things as a second driver. Beat your teammate. One thing as well that they always seem to do in this game is always the best tracks. Best ones, they always seem to make it fucking raining. I'm half expecting one day to make Bahrain or fucking... I've had it rain in Bahrain once. Ridiculous. Or like Abu Dhabi, I bet they make it rain in Abu Dhabi one day. It never rained at Abu Dhabi on the race day. I don't think it's even rained on fucking Qualies. Or practice.
The gap to the car ahead is 4.7 seconds.
Worst line ever. Constant vibrations on the tyres, and I can't go any slower, so I just basically won't be fucking moving. So it's just showing me, it's like, this is tearing your tyres apart. And fucking no game. And no controller. I want the slicks, but my Bell M team, they're like, meh, no. Intermediate, meh. Right over our belly.
We're still happy that we're on the right tyres at the moment.
I don't know. God, I was able to take it properly. Stuffle.
The tyre situation is an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got right now.
Tyre situation is an interesting one. Yeah, I know it's a fucking interesting one, mate. These things are getting torn to shreds. Barely get any fucking traction out of corners on them. Look at them, 16%, they've been on for what, 2 laps? Okay, so, my analysis so far of this game, they've improved the driving a lot, a hell of a lot. Like, the driving feels more fluid, it feels more realistic, the cars seem to handle a bit more true to how they should do, especially on the water. But the AI is fucking terrible. They smashed it last game and this one just seems shit. Like, they pull out some amazing strategy calls in the last game. Some amazing tyre calls. So far, this has just been shoddy. I've lost two... I came last in the race because of their decision to make me pit. Well, like third from last or whatever, and now I've had it happen again. Fucking second from last. Third from last, sorry. It's all because they were like, oh yeah, tyre strategy, pit. Well, do you know what? I'm not fucking listening to you guys anymore. I don't like that, though. That's the one aspect of this I don't like. They have made locking up so easy. I'm doing half compressions of the fucking brake pedal. Half compressions. Half compression, bit more, locks. It's got nothing to do with my braking distances. Braking distances are only changed by about 20 meters in the rain. It's not a lot, up to 50 in heavy rain. I'm just getting pissed off. I'm just gonna shut up now. Just gonna do these last 7 laps and I'm not gonna say a word.
Seconds.
pissing me off. And now it's just so fucking dry.
Situation, but I don't think we have cause to move on to a different tire yet.
Yeah, of course not. Look how good these are. Look at the amount of spray coming out the back. That was just both of those corners, just solid vibrations on the controller. Solid vibrations. Wasn't paying attention. I think I just went off to the right. Yeah, I did. What the fuck is going on? Not time for slicks now, but I just went purple in the first sector because I fucking worn down all of my fucking tread, and these essentially are slicks now. Sorry for people that watch this with the rewinds, but I'm fucking infuriated. If it was actually reasonable, I'd be like, yeah, fine. But I'm fucking furious. I've lost another good points. Well, I've lost points in another fucking race because of the fucking mechanics and their shitty calls. Leave this. Twice now. Now the track's fucking bone dry. The sun's starting to come out. And they're like, nah, just stay on them because, you know, it's the end of the race. You know I can barely drive these, right? Look at them.
The car behind is gaining on you by 5/10 a lap.
Great. I couldn't give two shits, to be honest. I just want this fucking race to be over. One of my favourite tracks. Fuck. If some dickhead messaged in to Codemasters and be like, oh, can we have it so that gives you decisions to make and it could be shocking. You're a twat. No fucking mechanic ever goes in with a decision knowing it's going to be shocking. None of us can do it now. Literally. Doesn't help, I've got no fucking front wing either. Well, not no front wing, but a highly damaged front wing. Just can't take that last corner. I just do not have the front wing for it, and I do not have the front end grip. Just can't do it. There is no water on the racing line whatsoever. There is no point in pitting. Fuck knows where Sorokin is. Oh, this fucking corner, mate. Never had this problem before, ever. Never with this corner. They've done something and they've just changed it. And it's just fucked.
3.2 seconds.
That was me trying my fucking balls off to get that around the corner then. Fucking barely did. I want to catch Ericsson just as kind of like, fuck you. 2 laps to do it though. Oh,
moving you
God.
To an arrow setting of -1, -1.
Didn't want that. That doesn't matter, does it? I'm not pitting. Oh, fuck, we get to finish on this lap. There you go. There you go. That fucking says it all. This AI has got no idea what it's fucking talking about. Half a lap ago. Oh, I think it's too wet on the racing line to think of anything other than intermediate. DRS just got enabled because it's dry enough. Chat absolute bollocks. That really annoys me as well. The amount of times you fucking push buttons on that bloody steering wheel. I know they do a lot of changes, you know, like 200 changes around
a bit worse for wear at this point. It's not going to be long before it pulls away from us completely. Stay alert.
Oh, Lewis put in the fastest lap. I was about to say, how's he fucking 2 laps ahead of me? I give up. I just don't fucking care anymore. Just let me finish this fucking race. But I've just been screwed over on. Driven fucking terribly after having these shitty tyres on in this fucking weather. I mean, look at it.
We're catching the car ahead, but be aware that these tyres need to last till the end of the race.
shame. It's a real shame they fucked the AI up. Like, they're turning in on you on corners, you can't do wheel-to-wheel racing. Jeff just chatting absolute shit. You're gaining the Gonda guy in front of you, but remember that these tyres have got to last to the end of the race. I've got half a lap left, Jeff. Just shut up and let me finish the fucking race. Just literally, that's all you have to do. Just shut up. Oh, why not? Why not have one more lock-up on the corner of fucks? The race is finished. You don't finish the last lap. Oh yeah, I've not been lapped. Yeah, of course. Go. Nothing fucking works again. Look at it. Look, it's just... Well, this has been great for F1 2018. I've had one race that I've enjoyed so far. Like, this is actually... One of the things that's actually annoyed me is how much this fucking controller is vibrating. Oh, I can barely feel my hands anymore. It's been vibrating so much. But look. Oh, the lock up. Of course it is. Fucking. I hope people find it funny. Me just getting angry at this. Rather than find it irritating. Because I'm just going to get no views. So I tell you now. If this game continues to be like this. Where. There's so much. There's a lot of good things, and I'm not lying, there are a lot of good things. It feels nice, it's handling well, but it's just the semantics of the car and the details of what it does and how it fucking works. It's just weird. No, you can fuck right off. See, look at this, look. I brake. I was braking to a fucking basic stop. And the computer was making go alongside me and brake at the same rate as I was. That is bullshit. I have never had this game do that before. And then I stopped, basically stopped on purpose after doing that corner. And he fucking stopped. Ah, fuck off, Charles. I'm just going to wheel you around and piss you right off. You can fuck right off. Enough of this bullshit. Look at it, look. I'm going to practically stop so I can turn the corner. Ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. You fucked up, Codemasters. All these people saying, oh, it's great. Oh, great my ass. Fuck off. Last game was the best game they'd ever made. The last one. This one. Fucking just.
So here they come now, out onto the podium.
I don't care. I don't care.
And now let's
take a look.
I don't
care. I don't care. Just skip everything. Get me to the interview. And just let me get out of it. I don't care. I don't care. I don't care.
We've received invitations to new historic events.
I don't care. Right, there we go. Thank you for anyone who did watch. I'll come back soon with another video. Goodbye.